A single proof gold eagle with nearly $500,000. Yes, it is true, and that is the glorious proof 1858 gold eagle that we will be taking a look at today. Now, while we can confirm the provenance of, and thusly reliably trace and affirm the existence of a total of 4 coins like this, 3 of those examples are impounded in permanent institutional collections. One in the National Numismatic Collection at the Smithsonian, another in the possession of the American Numismatic Society, and a third still is being curated by the Connecticut State Library, making this effectively the only coin of its type available to private collectors. It is likely that the mint didn't produce more than 6 of these coins total, although exact proof mintage figures of coins were not officially recorded in 1858, which was also the year that the mint began to formalize a program to strike proof coins on a more commercial basis under the direction of Mint Director James Ross Snowden, basically formalizing the sale of proof coins instead of the on-demand or almost buddy system-esque situation that was in play up until this point. Only a single die pair was used to strike all known examples of this coin, and with a mintage of only 4 to 6 coins suspected, that would make perfect sense. Interestingly, the reverse die was actually about 2 decades old at this point, having been used to strike the very intermittent proof gold eagles upon request for influential collectors and the like from around 1840 onwards. Now, the obverse die was later used to strike the regular business strike coins for circulation as well, although the die state on the circulation coins is significantly more advanced, confirming that the proof coins were in fact minted first, and then the die was transitioned to strike coins for circulation. Several die markers can be used to confirm this fact. The fact that stars 1 and 2 are particularly smooth. Star 2 also has a number of small defects on its edge that line up. Similar deformations can also be seen on star number 7. There is a small point to the northwest of one of the pearls tying up Liberty's hair. A very minor die chip, barely noticeable between the denticles and star 13, and then a small die scratch on Liberty's neck just below her earlobe, and the fact that the details on the ear were very obviously strengthened by hand. I could very well continue, but I think you get the point. Now, amazingly, the coin's provenance can be traced completely unbroken all the way back to its original purchase from the mint in 1858 by prominent Massachusetts collector George Seavey, who purchased this particular coin as a part of a complete gold, silver, and minor proof coin set for that year. It then made its way into the Parmelee collection, as well as the holdings of William H. Wooden, and all the way through a century and a half worth of history to the current sale. It was offered publicly for the first time since 1984 at the 2020 Central States US Coins Signature Auction as hosted by Heritage, a singular opportunity to own a coin that may very well not appear on the market again for several decades. Graded by NGC as a proof 64 Ultra Cameo, the coin saw a final price at auction of $480,000. Subscribe to WNN and activate notifications with the bell icon to know when new videos are released. For the World and Numismatic News, I am Numisman saying thank you for watching, stay safe, keep collecting, and have a great day.